Hello everyone, my name is Nikhil, your TutePad instructor, and in this After Effects tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how to create a really nice and professional looking logo reveal in After Effects from scratch. So without any further ado, let's get straight into the video and get started. Alright, so here we are in After Effects. So I'm going to start by creating a new composition. So let's click right over here and it's going to create a new composition. Let's rename this to main, because this is going to be our main composition. Let's set the HDTV 1080p. Let's make this 30 frames and 10 seconds looks good enough and hit OK. Then right off the bat, I'm going to select the polygon tool and just drag it just like that. Now you can use your arrow keys to increase the number of corners or decrease the number of corners. So we need 6 corners, so I'm going to keep it 6 just like that and hold shift just to be precise and just leave this up. So now we have it. Let's increase the stroke. Let's make it white first of all, and let's increase this to 2 pixels. There we go. And then I'm going to just set this in the center. Let's center the anchor point. So what I can do is I can select the anchor point tool and just drag in the anchor point in the center. So select the layer and make sure the snapping is turned on, and it's going to snap the anchor point here in the center. Then you can align it using the align tab. Let's center this out, and if your align tab isn't right over here, you can go into Windows and make sure the align tab right over here. Just click on it and it's going to give you this align tab. So now we have it. Let's rename this to 01, go into polystar 1, polystar path 1, and change the outer radius to 100 pixels. Just like that, and then we can go ahead and start animating the stroke. So to do that, I'm going to go into add and click right on this icon and then click trim paths, and now we can go ahead and animate the stroke just like that. You can hide the control layer just by clicking right over here so you can see it more properly, as you can see. So let's animate this. So I'm going to go to, let's say, maybe 1 second and 10 frames. Set this to 100 and click on the end stopwatch to create a keyframe. Go back in time and set this to 0. Then create a keyframe on the offset as well. So hit on the stopwatch to create a keyframe. Go back in time and set this to minus 90. So now we have something like this. Now the animation is pretty, you know, stable right now. So let's give it a really nice motion. So to do that, I'm going to select the keyframes, hit F9 to ease those keyframes, go into graph editor, select these keyframes, and right over here we have this handle. I'm going to drag it by holding shift just like that. So now we should have something like this. As you can see, looks really nice and, you know, subtle motion to it. Then what I can do is I can select this and hit Ctrl D to duplicate it and increase the stroke size to maybe 5 pixels. And then I'm going to change the color to whatever you like. I'm going to go with a blue color. You can set it to anything that you like. We'll make this red so we can see it more properly. Then I'm going to go into contents, polystar 1, polystar path 1. And I'm going to go into trim paths. And let's tweak some settings. I'm going to go to 10 frames. Bring these keyframes right over here. Go to maybe 1 second and bring this. We can hide the parent, we don't need to see it. Then let's go to 15 frames and create a keyframe on the start property just like that. Go to 1 second and 5 frames and let's set this up to 100. Let's select these keyframes, hit F9 to ease those keyframes. Go into graph editor and drag it just like that, just like we did before. So now we have something like that. As you can see, it gives a really nice feel to it, and I personally like it. So there we go, we are done with our base shape. Now what I can do is I can select this, both the layers, right click and click on pre-comp. Let's rename this to 01. You can rename it to anything that you like, of course. And then I'm going to duplicate it by hitting Ctrl D on the keyboard. Select the layer and hold shift and just drag it just like that. Let's go to where the animation is completed so we can see the corners. and just drag it just like that. Hit Ctrl D to duplicate it and drag it on the other side as well. You can use your arrow keys to be a bit more precise, just like that. Let's hit Ctrl D to duplicate it and place it right over here. Let's use the arrow keys. Yep, that looks pretty good. Hit Ctrl D to duplicate it, hold shift and just drag it just like that. There we go. Select these two layers, hit Ctrl D to duplicate it and just drag it holding shift just like that. Use your arrow keys whenever you want or whenever necessary. So let's see what we have. Okay, so this is looking pretty good. Now what I can do is, this is our center shape, so let's make this red so we can, you know, identify it. And then I'm gonna go into the composition, select this layers and hit Ctrl C to copy it, and go into our main composition and hit Ctrl V to paste it up. Then I'm gonna go into contents, polystyle 1, polystyle path 1, and change the outer radius to 300 pixels. And same for this one as well. So let's go into contents, polystyle 1, polystyle path 1, and set the outer radius to 300. So now we have something like that. So this is gonna be our bigger shape. So let's pre-comp this and call this big shape, maybe. Hit OK. Give it a different color so we can identify it. Let's make it blue. Then I'm gonna hit, go right over here, Ctrl C to copy it, go into main comp and hit Ctrl V to paste it up. Go into contents, polystyle path 1, and set the outer radius to 200. And the same for this one as well. Polystyle 1, polystyle path 1, set the outer radius to 200. So we have something like that. Let's pre-comp this and let's call this semi. Semi-center, maybe. So there we go. This is our center animation. Let's make this a different color, maybe a green. So now we have something like that. So let's displace them to make it look even more cool. So now what I can do is, I can go to 10 frames, maybe. Let's displace them by 5 frames. Select all the layers except the center one and the big one. And let's move them just like that. So now we have something like this, maybe a bit more. Maybe I'll go with 10 frames. Let's go right over here. We have something like that. And I'm gonna displace the semi-center as well. So let's place it right over here. And then what I can do is, I can select the big shape, hit Ctrl D to duplicate it, hit R to bring down the rotation properties and rotate it by 180 degrees. So now we have something like this. Same for the center one as well. Hit Ctrl D, hit R to bring down the rotation properties and rotate it to 180 degrees. So now we have something like this. And as you can see, it looks really, really nice and complex. And it's really simple to do. So let's go to around 10 frames, 1 second and 10 frames. Let's close this up. And now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go into the center one. Let's bring down the property of the blue one, polystyle 1, and I'm gonna animate the fill. So let's set this up to 0 for now. Let's give it a white color and make sure it's turned on. Let's zoom in a bit by holding Alt and scroll wheel. Let's create a keyframe on the opacity, go to around 20 frames. Let's go to 25 frames and set this up to 100. So now we have a basic fill animation just like that. Now if I go into my main comp, we should have something like that. As you can see, really simple. So let's go to 2 seconds and 10 frames. And then what I can do is, I can select these layers, hit P to bring down the position properties. Click on the position stopwatch to create a keyframe. Go to around 3 seconds and let's move them around. So let's select this shape and move it right over here. Make sure to turn off the snapping so we can be a bit more precise. So let's place it something like that. Select this one, place it just like that. This one, move it just like that. This one, just dragging it just like that. Just drag it just like that. And there we go. So now we have a basic animation just like that. To make it look even more cool, so let's select the keyframes, hit F9, go to graph editor and select the keyframes and drag this handle just like that. Now we should have something like that. Maybe I'll increase the time a bit, so maybe let's go to 3 seconds and 10 frames and drag this keyframes holding shift. So it's gonna snap in at the current time indicator. So now we have something like that. Really simple to do. Then what I can do is, and go to right over here, select the shapes or the composition, hit S to bring down the scale properties, create a keyframe on the scale property, go right over here at 4 seconds, or let's go to 4 seconds and 10 frames and scale them down to 0. So now we have something like that. You can see, so we can select the keyframes, or this keyframe. I mean, let's select the all the keyframes and hit F9 to easy ease those keyframes. Go to graph editor and create a peak just like we did before, just like that. So we have a really nice motion just like that. So we can select the keyframes, hit ctrl C to copy it and paste it on our center composition as well. So let's hit ctrl V and ctrl V on both of them. So we have something like that. And then I'm going to, let's say 4 seconds, and scale this down as well. So let's select all the shapes, not all the shape, but the semi-center and the big shape, and hit ctrl V to paste up the keyframes. So now those composition has the keyframes as well. So it's gonna just, you know, close it up just like that. Maybe I'll just drag it at the same timing to make it look even more cool. So it's really simple to create this animation, as you can see. So we have our animation ready. So now what I can do is, first of all, close this up and pre-comp this. So let's pre-comp it and let's rename this to anything that I want. I'm gonna rename this to animation and hit OK. So now we have our basic animation, which looks really, really cool. Now what I can do is I can hit Ctrl D to duplicate it and select the second layer and rename this to matte. Let's drag in our logo. Let's put it between both of the composition. Or maybe what I can do is I can select this animation and let's put the logo below our matte. Let's close this animation for now. And then I'm gonna set the track matte to alpha inverted. So as you can see, we have something like that. Now the animation is revealing our logo and we can scale this down a bit to around 80%. Turn on our animation and we have something like that. You can see. Now what I can do is I can go right over here at 2 seconds and 15 frames and crop our logo and matte by holding alt and close bracket just like that. So now we should have something like this. As you can see, really simple and easy to create. Let's scale down a logo the bit, maybe around 80%. There we go. Looks pretty good. Now what I can do is I can select all the layers and pre-comp this again, and let's call this our main composition. We already have our main comp, so let's call this main animation. Let's create a background. So I'm gonna hit Ctrl Y to create a new solid. Let's name this to PG for background and hit OK. And then I'm gonna go here and type in for color gradient, so 4-C for four color gradient, and drag it onto the BG solid layer. Let's set this to something like blue, something like that. Select the green and make it really, really dark, almost kind of a black dark blue, something like that. And give this point the same color just like that. I can increase the jitter so we don't get any color bending. So I'm gonna set this to 25% and increase the blend to 250. And then I can select this point and just put it right over here. Let's drag it just like that. There we go. Let's create a new solid, and this time I'm going to rename this to grid and hit OK. And I'm going to type in grid right over here. Let's select the grid, which is under the generate effect. Let's drag and drop it right over here. And let's set this to width and height sliders so it's equally distributed. Let's set the borders to 1 pixels. And let's increase the width to, let's go with 100. And this to 100 as well. I think that is a bit too big. Maybe let's go with 30. And this to 30 as well. Yep, that looks pretty good. And set the blending mode to overlay. So now we have something like that. Now, by the way, if your blending mode tab is not visible, you can just click right over here and it's going to be visible just like that. So we have our background ready. Let's select these two layers and drag this behind. So now we have our really nice background. So let's add some shadows, which is going to give a little bit more depth to the scene. So to do that, I'm going to select the main animation and hit Ctrl D to duplicate it. Select the below layer and add an effect called CC scale wipe. There we go. Let's drag it into our main animation too. And then I can increase this just like that, as you can see. Till the time I get this kind of straight lines. Then I'm going to add an effect called tint. Double click on it. So it's going to add it just like that. And let's set this to black as well. So now we have our shadow right off the bat. And obviously it's just too much. You can rotate it at any angle that you want. Something like that. I'll keep it. And add one more effect called linear wipe. There we go. Let's drag and drop it just like that. So there we have it. So let's drag this according to our requirements. I'm going to increase this, and you can see we have this kind of a crop effect. So I'm going to rotate this according to our requirements. So let's keep rotating. By the time I get the required result, maybe I'll bring this down to maybe around 25. There we go. And keep rotating it just like that. And fiddle this up to 1000. So now we have something like that. And now you can anytime go right over here and hit T to bring down the opacity and play around with the opacity according to your requirements. I'm going to leave it somewhere around there. And there we have a really nice looking logo reveal. So let's see our complete animation. So let's go right over here. Let's play this up. Yep, that is looking pretty good. Let's add some color correction. So I'm going to create a new adjustment layer. Let's rename this to CC for color correction. And let's add a curves to it. So let's type in curves. Let's drag and drop it right over here. And I'm going to do a little bit of adjustment just like that. Maybe a little bit right over here. Drag this up. So you can see the difference before and after. It's really nice and subtle, and it looks really, really cool. Let's add some glow as well. So select this and type in glow. Let's go to stylize glow and let's drag and drop it right over here and set the glow threshold to 80% and bring down the intensity to 0.7 and the radius to 6. And it's going to add some really nice glow to our animation. You can see. And this is looking really, really good, as you can see. And it's really simple to create and really easy. So I hope this video helps you guys to make something really cool and creative. And I'll see you in my next video. Till then, take care and thank you so much for watching, guys.